you an hour to get over that. A lot of people never got past it. Prod and poke at it, exploring the limits of your reach and your strength, trying to find a way up. There's a sense of truth in that lack of compromise. Most obstacles in video game worlds are fake. Completely confident in your ability to get through them. Once you have the correct method, or the correct equipment, or just by spending enough time. In that sense, every pixelated obstacle in Sexy Hiking is real. The obstacles in Sexy Hiking are unyielding, and that makes the game really frustrating. But I'm not sure Jazzro intended to make a frustrating game. The frustration is just essential to the act of climbing, and it's authentic to the process of building a game about climbing. A funny thing happened to me as I was building this mountain. I'd have an idea for a new obstacle, and I'd build it, test it, and it would usually turn out to be unreasonably hard. But I couldn't bring myself to make it easier. It already felt like my inability to get past a new obstacle was my fault, as a player rather than as a builder. Imaginary mountains built themselves from our efforts to climb, and it's our repeated attempts to reach the summit that turns those mountains into something good. When you're building a video game world, you're building with ideas. And that can be like working with quicksand cement. You mold your ideas into a certain shape that can be played with. And in the process of playing with them, they begin to harden and set until they're immutable, like rock. And at that point, you can't change the world. Not without breaking it into pieces and starting fresh with new ideas. For years now, people have been predicting that games would soon be made out of prefabricated objects, bought in a store and assembled into a world. And for the most part, that hasn't happened. The objects in the stores are trash. I don't mean they look bad, but they're badly made, although a lot of them are. I mean they're trash in the way that food becomes trash as soon as you put it in the sink. Things are made to be consumed and used, and once the moment is gone, they transform into damage. In the context of technology, those moments pass by in seconds. Over time, we've poured more and more refuse into this vast digital landfill that we call the internet. It now vastly outnumbers and outweighs the things that are fresh and untainted and unused. If everything around us is cultural trash, trash becomes the new medium, the lingua franca of the internet age. You can build culture out of trash, but only trash culture. B games, B movies, B music. Maybe this is what digital culture is. A monstrous mountain of trash, the ash heap of creativity's fountain. A landfill with everything we ever thought of in it. Grand, infinite, and assorted. There's 3D models of breakfast, Gen X's fanfic novels, scan magazines, green screen Shia LaBeouf, banned snuff scenes on Live Leak. Facebook's got lifelike bots with unbranded adverts and candid shots of Kanye and Taylor Swift mashups, car crash epic failed GIFs, Russian dashcam vids, discussions of McRibs, discarded, forgotten, unrecycled, muddled, rotten, untitled. Everything's fresh for about 6 seconds, until some newer thing beckons, and we hit refresh. And there's years of persevering, disappearing into the pile, out of style, out of sight. There's a chance that you're playing this. What I'm saying is, trash is disposable, but maybe it doesn't have to be approachable. What's the feeling like? Are you stressed? I guess you don't know if you got this far. Feeling frustrated. It's underrated. An orange is sweet, juicy fruit locked inside a bitter peel. That's not how I feel about a challenge. I only want the bitterness. It's coffee. It's grapefruit.